Your Excellency Sergeant Markan, former President of Seychelles. Your Excellency Amani Karume, former President of Zanzibar. Ambassador Harold Doli, U.S. Representative to the African Development Bank. Dr. Yum Moon, International Chairman and Founder, Global Peace Foundation, with his amiable wife, Dr. Mrs. Moon, Dr. Aruna Chandevia and his amiable wife, His Eminence Cardinal John Oyekan, Archbishop of Abuja, other clergy here present, our chief host, ably represented Alhaji Bala Muhammad, our royal fathers, distinguished delegates, ladies and gentlemen. I am highly and greatly honored and pleased to welcome you all to this banquet organized as part of activities for the 2013 Global Peace Leadership Conference. It is indeed a conference that is aimed at promoting reconciliation, mutual respect, harmony, and cooperation so as to have lasting and sustainable peace. First, let me convey the greetings of Her Excellency, Dr. Dame Patience Jonathan, the First Lady of the Federal Republic of Nigeria and President African First Lady's Peace Mission, who had wanted to be here herself, but for some urgent national issues. She has, however, asked me to convey her best wishes for this successful conference. The First Lady, as you know, has over the years demonstrated commitment and promotion of peace in Nigeria and across Africa, which underscores the importance she attaches to this conference. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, peace has increasingly become a common good, a foundation for a sustainable nation building, an overarching link to development. It is in the light of this that His Excellency President Goodluck Ebele Jonathan took practical and decisive steps to tackle terrorism and insecurity on one hand, and he is dedicated, on the other hand, to the imperatives of peace in all aspects. The latter, as we all know, requires additional concerted efforts and complementaries as exemplified by the Institute of Peace and Conflict Resolution and the Global Peace Foundation as they further carry the public-private partnership for peace forward. It is in the unity of purpose that this will be achieved, the unity of the nation, hence the unity of the globe. Just as the saying goes, together we stand, divided we fall. It is in this support and partnership that we are seeking from you all over. I hope at the end of this conference, we will have a pragmatic and credible framework for creating short and long-term roadmap for peace and unity in Nigeria and the world at large. Your Excellencies, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, permit me to express my heartfelt appreciation to all those who have contributed in organizing this conference, particularly Global Peace Foundation and the Institute for Peace and Conflict Resolution. I want to sincerely express my unreserved appreciation, not only to the leaders that have put this together, but indeed to all those that have come from across the globe. We want to thank you for choosing Nigeria for this occasion. But indeed, all our staff also, we thank them. I also want to thank all the efforts that have been made to achieve this edition in our beloved country. It is on this note, dear leaders, that I wish us a fruitful discussion and deliberation. I thank you all for your contributions for peace towards a prosperous tomorrow. We hope you enjoy your stay in Nigeria, you will enjoy our hospitality as Nigerians, and we hope that from now, whatever we gain from this conference, we will share it with all our sisters and brothers across the globe. Once again, on behalf of myself and the Nigerian chapter of the Global Peace Foundation, I warmly welcome you to Nigeria. I believe in peace. Thank you.